Hey everyone, this is Silly Science with Simon, and today I'm going to show you how to make a small air cannon and a giant air cannon that shoot these awesome rings of smoke. Check it out! Are you ready? Let's get started. To make the small air cannon, you're going to need to grab a few things. A paper or plastic cup, a balloon, some scissors, some tape, and a coin. Start by cutting a small hole in the bottom of your cup. This is where you can use the coin to draw it out first, and you should probably get an adult to help you. Next, take a balloon and blow it up to stretch it a little bit. Then you want to cut the balloon in half and throw away the bit that you usually tie up. Take the other half and stretch it over the top of the cup. If you want, you can take the balloon to the cup to make sure it doesn't go anywhere. And there you have it, a small air cannon. Now you can't see it, but this is shooting out blasts of air at me. One way to see it is using a confetti gun. With all this confetti around, you're gonna be able to see that blast of air. Now, if you don't have a confetti gun, then there is something else that you can use. I've got a few sticks of incense, and what I'm gonna do is just light the ends of them and blow those ends out. You can see that this incense is now making a whole heap of smoke. I'm just gonna put them into the cup. All right, this cup is now full of smoke. I'm just gonna take the incense out and then just tap the end. One way to help you see it a bit better is to grab a darker background. However, a better way to see the smoke rings, rather than using a dark background, is to just use a bigger air cannon. Instead of using a cup, we're going to use a garbage bag. Instead of using a balloon to cover the top of that cup, we're going to use a piece of clear PVC. And instead of putting that into place with some tape, we're going to use these bungee cords. Check out the description or leave a comment if you want to know where you can find any of these things. Now for this bit, you're definitely going to need an adult's help. We're going to have to cut a hole in the bottom of this garbage bin. Grab yourself a Stanley knife and a flame. Now what I like to do is just soften the plastic a little bit with the flame and then use the Stanley knife to cut it. But it's pretty hard, so as I said, grab an adult to get some help. You might need to repeat this a few times as the plastic starts to harden again. Alright, that's the hard bit done. Now to finish off your giant air cannon, you're going to want to grab this piece of clear PVC and put it over the top. Then to secure it in place, grab yourself your bungee cords, link them together and tie them around a couple of times. Now we've got ourselves a giant air cannon which shoots out a lot more air. Alright, this time we're going to make those smoke rings again. But instead of using incense, we're going to use something with a bit more power. And for that, I'm talking about my smoke machine.
Hey Beck, I'm just about to use the smoke machine inside.
I'm here in the garage and I'm going to show you the smoke rings we can make with the giant air cannon. Check this out.
Whoa!
Hey, let me know how you go with making your own air cannon. I'll be putting up new videos every second Friday, so stay tuned for more silly science. I better go fix this smoke machine.